Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel, and in our today's video we will see how we can align a flow sheet or how we can prepare a good flow sheet in Aspen Plus. Obviously we have simulated various processes in Aspen Plus and even in Aspen Hyses, but this is the first video after so many videos on this channel that we will be discussing that how we can prepare a good flow sheet and what are the good flow sheet practices. So if you have not subscribed to this channel yet, please do subscribe to the channel. Click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So now what we do once we get to the simulation environment, we have model played over here. First we need to do is to go to this view block, and these are the options for display aids: grid, snap, scale. Once we click on this grid, then you can see that the grid is appeared over here. I will make it a bit enlarged so that we get a good flow sheet over here. We can even change its size, like we can take it to 1 or we could make it 2.1. So there are different options available in it. Now once we click on the snap, it gives align objects with grid when placed, moved or resized, that it will follow these grid lines while you are moving the block or you are aligning the block. So we will click on the snap. Next is the scale, which display grid units along the edges of the flow sheet, like this x-axis and this y-axis. The 0 represents the center point usually, but in that case, like, it is minus values and these are the plus values. If we zoom it in, then these will reduce. If we zoom it out, then accordingly these will increase. And the 0.1, like if we take it to the 1, and if we zoom it, then you can see the difference is one point between these. While if you take it to 0.5, the difference will increase. 0.2, as you can see, the difference is now decreasing and you will get more blocks. So I will like take it as a 0.5. Now in this diagram, for example, we will first select the mixer and let's say that it is placed at this -2, and accordingly a stream is connected. Let's say it is, if I zoom it out to get more grid units, and you can see that, for example, it is at -2 now, and we take it to these 2 points only. And accordingly, if it is at 2 points here, like the center point is -2 and this is -4, then accordingly it will lie at 0. And now you can see that the inlet line, this one, and the outlet line, these are balanced lines. These are equal in length. Now, for example, if it has like the heater block over here, which is placed somewhere here over. So what you need to do, you need to connect it, and even you can see, like, you can move it across the grid lines. That is why the snap roll is very, very important. And accordingly, you could place it over here and then control A, control B to align. These lines can be used as well. So now you can see the block, this block is at 0 point, this block is at -2 points. Then, like, accordingly we will further extend it, and I mean you can simply check out the lengths, the dimensions of the block. Now if you take the separator over here, like the flat separator, which is -2, 0, and now we'll take it as 2 now. And then accordingly we double click on it and connect it with it, and we make vertical lines. Now you can see 1, 2, 3. So accordingly 1, 2 and 3. So we will place it over here like that to make it equal looking. And this line is starting from 2, ending at 3. You can take it to 3.5 as well to make it a good look as well. But now you can see these are the equally spaced lines and these are ending at the same point. Well, if you do not have these grid, snap, scale, then obviously you will see you will have some different alignment over here. Similarly, these lines, like you can see, this one is here 1, 2, 3, this one is here 1, 2 and 3, and accordingly it is connected over here. And accordingly this line is a bit, you can say, a bit more line, but again these lines are nearly equal and you get the information from this scale. Now let's say that it has heat exchanger over here. Just I'm assuming the functions, and this one is at 4 now, -2, 0, 2 and now 4, and it is connected over here as like the hot stream, and if we move it over here, and even if we can move it over here like that as well. Or even if it is one, then it will be much more rigorous, like it will move like that. Or we can simply control A, control B to align the blocks. And let's say that if this block is move over here, then it will move across these lines over here as well. And we can also use the option of realign, reroute the stream or blocks alignment as well. Like we can move it over here and then we can move it over here, or we can simply place it over here across these grid lines as well. Accordingly, like you can see, if we take it, it's out, then you can see it will move like this one. And if a cold stream is entering over here, then you can see the same inlet points and the same outlet. So you can see, I mean, this can be arranged in a much better way if you use the grid snap scale options over here, and you can align this, like you can align as using arrows option as well, like it was earlier. If we to take it above, click on this above arrow or below arrow, or you have to increase the line right arrow, decrease the line left arrow. And if you have to align all this control A, control B to align all the options over here. So this is the best tool, this grid snap scale, to prepare your flow sheet. Now if I take the print of this flow sheet, what I need to do, go to this file, print preview, to get the print preview of this diagram. And if I click on this print and go to this Microsoft print to PDF, then it will obviously give me the information about the PDF, and it will give the PFD in the PDF. Or you can simply take like a copy paste this one, control C, and open your paint, and you can simply take your diagrams to the paint as well, so that your diagrams would be visible over there as well. Like you can see, this diagram is easily taken here, and now you can make it like as per your own requirements. So that's how the grid snap scale and option is used to prepare a good flow sheet in Aspen Plus, and accordingly you get a better flow sheet, a better representation in Aspen Plus. Because you know, you are getting a simulation skill that is good, but if your data is not representable, if your flow sheet is not representable, then obviously, I mean, it is of no worth because of its non-representation. Like we publish research articles, we publish various things, and these must be in a presentable form for an effective representation at the processes or at the some conferences, some research articles, journals, and so on, some presentations as well. So that's how you prepare a good flow sheet using Aspen Plus and using its features of display aids. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.